speaking? What did, who did the Bible say is speaking?
Moses.
You see, some of you is not, you are not concentrating. You just read that and you forget. Moses is now speaking. Do we get that?
Yes.
Moses is speaking to who?
Israel.
To the children of Israel. Okay, verses 2.
Yeah.
Let me go from go ahead, I said to till 8.
And there is a fast and don't twist it there in the 11th month, on the first day of the month, that Moses spake unto the children of Israel according to all that the Lord had given him in commandments of his
land. According to what? According to everything that the Lord told him to tell the children of Israel. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Go ahead.
After he has
said Shiloh, and the king of Amorites, which is where the Hebrew and Hor, the king of Bashan, which dwelt at Hachor in heaven. On this side, Jordan, in the land of Moab, began Moses to declare his laws, saying,
now the Bible said, listen, the Bible said Moses was speaking to the children of Israel. And he was giving them the commandment that the Lord sent him to tell them, right?
Yes.
Now, the Bible said Moses began to declare what the Lord sent him, the law. Now, listen. 6. Go ahead.
The Lord hath spoken to us in Horeb, saying, he hath dwelt long enough in this mountain.
Please wait. The Lord our God spoke to us in Horeb, saying, you have dwelled long enough in this mountain. In other words, you have dwelled long enough where you was before you got here today. The Lord is telling them, I have a new beginning for you.
Hallelujah.
That is my message today. You have dwelled long enough where you was yesterday. But the Lord sent me as he sent Moses to the children of Israel. You have dwelled long enough in that position. Enough is enough. Now, 7.
And change your journey, and go to the mount of Amorites, and to all the places near the mountain, in the plain, in the hills, and in the vale, and in the south, and by the seaside, to the land of the Canaanites, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the river Euphrates. Behold, I have set the land before you. Go in and possess the land which is God swears unto your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give unto them and to their seed after them.
Hallelujah. Behold, I have set the land before you and you and you and me.
Amen.
Go in and possess the land,
yes,
which the Lord swore to your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, to give to them and to their children after them. Beloved, I come to tell you this morning, the title of my sermon today, I have been saying it since Thursday, but I didn't preach on it because those of you that are not here might not know that the Lord has put in the atmosphere new beginning.
Amen.
And if I didn't tell you, bring it back on Sunday, only the Thursday people will begin to prophesy new beginning. So for you to know and hear what heaven has established in this church for now, heaven asked me to tell you, I am doing something new. He said, all your past, forget it.
Amen.
Forget your past.
Amen.
Somebody tell your neighbor, the Lord say, forget your past.
The Lord say, forget your past.
Yes. He said, I'm doing a new thing.
I'm doing a new thing.
He said, now you will see it. He said, now, if you are connected enough on this mountain this morning, you must see it.
Amen.
He asked me to tell you, forget about your past shame. Forget about it. Some of us, we have done something in the past that we're not boastful or proud to tell anybody. Yes. I remember in my other church, they said the woman that bring the church to New York, she was once a prostitute. She was a prostitute. And her husband used to come from America, go on vacation to Africa, and they were customers. They were customers. And one day the man said, "You want to marry me?" And the lady said, "I'm a prostitute, though. We don't marry." And the man said, "Well, I know you're a prostitute, you don't need to tell, but I want to take you to America." And that's how he married her and brought her to America. And she was the one that planted my church in from her living room. New beginning. What? Where are you today that you thought it can't change? What is it that you are going through and you want to get stopped? Rewind the lie of the enemy in your head. The Lord said, "I will do a new thing if you can just believe me. If you can just let your past be your past, I will blow your mind up."
Amen.
Some of us were stuck in the husband that left us and the wife that is gone. Some of us are still looking for ways to spite our husbands, our wives. You haven't paid the child support. You haven't paid the child support. You keep appearing in their home, messing up the other marriage, the new marriage. That is not nice. That is holding on to your past. That is telling the enemy, "My God is not big." Because if you know that your God is bigger than life, you don't need to go and be pesting anybody's life. The Lord that gave the person that you are going to ask money from can give you two. So you don't need all that nonsense. I'm begging you. Let me tell you, what people think about you does not matter. It does not matter. You know some people, they can meet, your enemy can meet your church member on the way and say, "Oh, you go to Shadow of the Almighty. Oh, do you know sister so? I hear she's there. Don't move close to her. She's the devil." When she was in our church, she fought everybody. Is she still fighting there? Don't move close to her. I have had it. People will call me and say, "Pastor, I hear you are the pastor for Shadow of the Almighty Bronze." "Yes, ma'am." "There's somebody in your church. This, that. All I will say is thank you. Because there's always a new beginning.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
So I cannot, who am I to judge anybody with their past? I have a past too, don't you? I do. It was by the grace of God I am standing before you. It's not by might, it's not by power, it's not by eloquence, it's not by the Bible that I read. It's by the grace of God.
That's right.
Do you want to know how many phone calls I get about you that you won't even think the person called me? That is how human beings are wicked. Wicked. Let me tell you, if God has not taken me through fire, I will not be the pastor I am. The Bible said, Jesus said, "I am a priest that has been through all this suffering. So I know your sufferings. I know."
It's not man. I fear God more than that. The woman of Samaria, everybody hates her. She comes to fetch water when there is nobody at the well because of the wickedness of women. But Jesus met her, and Jesus was talking to her. Because why? Jesus don't care about your past. He wants your future. He wants your future. He said, forgetting those things that are behind. Forget about it. And press forward for the mark of God, which is before you. Some people will say, did you know my father slept with me when I was little? That was the past. I can't say I know your pain. But don't be trapped, please. What the enemy wants to do is to trap you to waste people's life. Yes. My brother slept with me, and I can't even tell my mom. And you will see the people damage, really damage. My mom's boyfriend or man slept with me, and I'm damaged. It's enough to damage person, I know. But please, you are like putting your life in a soap if you let it damage you. If you let it damage you. Isn't that what the enemy want? That's why he capture kids from little and put some things in their life that as they are growing up, they never be the same. And most of the dads or the uncles, they are gone and dead. And you are still here and can't balance your life. Please, I'm begging somebody today that this message is talking to. Break free from people's rumor. Break free. You know what? I don't care what you say about me. Me, I don't care. Sometimes you hear people talk about you, it pisses you like dagger. But you know what? As long as I think it a little bit, I just say, that is the devil's devices. My enemy is the one that owns the sorrow, not me. I just say that to myself. I don't want no sorrow. It's you that own the sorrow. The Bible said, as he come, so he shall go. Amen. Do you know that the enemy wants to get at you? It's not the rumor. It's you that the enemy wants to damage. I pray that you understand this sermon today. And take charge of your life. To know, the Bible says, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of God in you must understand. You must understand. You know, I was back in Africa and near my best brother. We started to antagonize each other. I thank you for your prayers, because otherwise we would beat each other. He said something and I said, why are you talking like that? He said, don't tell me what to say. I said, I hope you're not depressed, mister. He said, no, who are you talking to? I said, it's you. I said, why are you talking like that? I said, you're a Christian child. You was born a Christian, you grew up a Christian. What are you talking about? He said, all these pastors, they're just taking people's money. They're just eating people's money. They're just this, they're just that. I said, look, mister, you better mind your own business. I said, because if you don't mind your own business, that means you are jealous of these people. I said, because if you are not jealous, if it's me, God gave all those people, you will have been there and say, my sister. I say, it's other people you can talk about. Somebody is talking about your sister too. He said, oh, I say, yes, I'm telling you the truth. I'm telling you the truth. Somebody is talking about your sister too. And he was angry with me. He said, when I talk, don't talk. I said, yes, I know. But you are not talking sense right now. No. You know, people will judge you just to take your life away from you. Where you are, the thought is not supposed to be you. What that they didn't think you will still be standing. And you want them to lie to you and take your life from you while you are being in sorrow and they are enjoying. Because all they want to do is to get you down. God will not let them get you down.
Amen.
Do you know some of us, the nickname they gave us when we were in school still affects some of our lives? Some of us they call Dodo. In Yoruba, they say, Ode, Omo Ode. And that person grow up depressed and lonely for the rest of their life just because of one devil that sent kids to go and be saying nonsense. And kids get trapped in that and they begin to grow up. And people will say, you don't talk. I don't have nothing to say. Because the person feels less. Less. You remember they call some people zombie. Zombie. Please, I'm begging you. Whatever they call you, or you, even your parents, because some parents too, they call their kids nickname.
Yep.
And don't you be telling your child, look at your leg short, look at your leg long, look at your arm just like your dad. Look at, no. Because these are things that affect children after years. Don't do that. The Lord said, I am doing a new thing. Don't let the world define you. And I've been saying that and I say it over and over again. Don't let the world define you. You tell the world who you are. You tell the world who you are. Whatever people say that you hear, that you see, don't worry about it. Just make sure you carry yourself high. Somebody tell your neighbor, carry yourself high. Oh yes, carry yourself high. Some people can call it pride. Don't worry, carry yourself high. Somebody say, you can do anything, send me to go anywhere, but don't abuse me. Use me, but don't abuse me. Don't abuse me. Jesus said to the withered, the man that his hand was withered in the Bible. He met him and he said, stretch your hand. Beloved, have you imagined that? Just as I'm talking to you this morning, that is a new beginning. Only those that believe it will see it. Only those that walk and said, Lord, I hear you say new beginning. I want to see it in my own life. Only those that will see it. The Lord walked to the man, he said, stretch your hand. And I'm telling you, if that was in this place, in this day, they would say, is Jesus blind? Can't you see that the man's hand is withered? What does he mean by stretch your hand? Hello, Jesus, what are you talking about? And the man had it and thought about it a little bit. Mr. Preacher, you didn't see the hand is lifeless. But he summoned courage Is there anyone here that will summon courage? This and it's like, and the hand was stretched. This is the kind of faith the Lord is asking from you. The faith to close the door against what has troubled your life. The faith to believe, dare to understand what I'm saying to you this afternoon. That if God said it's a new beginning for you, it is a new beginning. For those that believe, for those that can get off everything that has trapped their life and set themselves free today. To my bedroom and I closed the door on myself for 3 days. I said, Lord, I don't want to borrow from anyone. I don't want to beg from nobody. I don't know what to do right now, but I think there is shame coming and I need you, and I need you right now. And I was in that bedroom for 3 days. And I began to seek the Lord. All I did was from my bedroom to the toilet. From my bedroom to the bathroom. And I go back. And I will sleep, vision will come. You know, when you are with the Lord, you will see vision. How many of you are fasting every once in a week? Yes, please keep it. And look. If the Holy Spirit said to you, it's not enough, do more. Did you hear me? If the Holy Spirit said it's not enough, that means what you are battling with, that time you are using is not enough to kill it. So don't say, Pastor BC say, I should fast one day and I fast to 12 and that's it. No, it's you and God. My last meal sometimes is Thursday, and I don't eat until we finish service here. It's what the Holy Spirit said. Sometimes I'll be tired and I'm sick, Lord, I'm tired. I need to eat. Like last Sunday, I said, God, I haven't slept. I'm tired. If I don't eat something, my enemy might collapse. So let me eat something. And that was, you know, it's between me and the Holy Spirit. You know, I'm telling you the truth, how to deal with the Lord. And I was in that office and I began to put something in my mouth quick before I come out here. But from this Thursday, I shut my mouth. Because why? The battles have to be won. And the Bible said this kind of things cannot happen without fasting and prayer. The kind of thing you are dealing with, nobody has told you from where you are coming from that you need confrontation with the demons. You need to confront your problems. You need to say, you need to move. Not here anymore. I was in that room. Within the 3 days, the Lord came and spoke. And the Lord said, this is what you will do. Do this. And that was what sustained me when I didn't have papers. Beloved, look, what you are looking for is right there with you. What you are looking for is right there by your side. If your spiritual eyes is closed, you can't see nothing. And if you don't seek the Lord, go to the Lord and say, Lord, I want to see you. You can't see nothing. It will be the same year after year. Even though I didn't have papers the next week, the next day, but I have a word. I have a word in my heart. And that settles everything. It settles it. And he said to me, said, I will sustain you. I will not let you beg for bread. And beloved, even though I may not have thousands in my hand, billions in my hand, it did sustain me. And the thing is, people don't have the understanding how God's work. And if somebody goes to fasting like that, all they want to see is the next week, let it happen. Sometimes it does happen the next day. Sometimes it does happen the next week. But sometimes it takes God to sort it out for you. It might be the people you are going to meet, they are still in China. It takes him time to prepare their heart to meet you.
Oh yes, thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Maybe what you are looking for in life, where he wants to take you, maybe they haven't met the law yet. It takes him time to go to the heart of those people when it's time for them to make the law that will favor you, and you begin to live the promises that he has given to you.
Oh yes.
But some of us don't understand that. We're quick to drop it. It's not working. I'm leaving. It's not working. I think I need to look on the other side.
Thank you.
It's not working. I think there's no power here. It's not working. I think I have to call my friend. But what you don't know is you are still coming back to the Lord. No matter how you think you can run, you are still coming back. Let me give you an example. The people of Israel, the journey they are supposed to do for 40 days. It took 40 years. Because of why? Disobedience. Which we all do. Disobedience. The Lord said, just give it to me. Give it to me. And you give it to him and you still put your hand on it. Is that giving? What you give and you turn and you leave it at the cross. They left Egypt. They were the one crying. Oh, this pain is too much. I carried brick yesterday until my back can't even rise. Until I can't pick my daughter up. And the Lord said, I hear the groanings of my people. I need a deliverer. Moses, I have made you, I have ordained you even from your mother's womb that you will be the deliverer for these people. And Moses took them. They haven't even gone far before they start grumbling. Why are you bringing us here? Is it because there's no grain in Egypt? Okay, where is water? Where is food? Where is chicken? Where is turkey? Where is garlic? Where is onion? Where are Moses? You are, they used to say in my language that you are saving the chicken not to go and die, but he refused. He wants to go. The Lord is trying to save them. And all they're doing in return is rebelling. Mm-hmm. Rebelling. And it's the same thing with us too. Every day, the Lord is looking at us and saying, why are you going to that direction? I gave you my word already. I said I will do it. Who asked you to be knocking doors that you are not supposed to knock? He said, I am giving you a new beginning. Let your past be your past. Because to be honest with you, we can be billions here. If somebody didn't understand how the word of God works, they might be left behind. They might be left behind. And wherever you go, nobody can do it for you except God.
Yes.
And if you are not careful, if you keep looking desperately where the Lord is not there, the they will give you another thing that is not supposed to be.
Oh yes.
And that will make the life worse than what you was before. Before, because in other words, you have been captured.
Mm-hmm.
You have been captured. Think about how many people that has been captured in the churches. Think about it. They said they see miracles.
Uh-huh.
Right? The miracle that you count as miracle is the miracle that you labor for yourself. It's the miracle that you go to the Lord and the Lord give it. It's not the miracle that they gave to you when they lay their hands upon you and they give you an husband. That's what you went there for. And you get home, the husband is bisexual. You know why? Because you went to the devil to ask for miracle. And he gave you one of their people. That's what they do. That's what they do. And if it's not bisexual,